people need to be realistic.
Do you get? I mean, if they forgive her for anything she did throughout the week, I don't see forgiveness coming for this one.
Love is truly a beautiful thing if you find one. Hello guys, welcome back again to my YouTube channel. My name is Vicky, and if you see me for the very first time, hi. Please consider to hit on that red subscribe button and subscribe to my YouTube channel, and do not forget to turn on your notification bell so that YouTube will inform me whenever I post a new video. Guys, let us just go straight into this video. Like, I don't want to be rambling and going all about again. Yesterday night, after the Saturday night party, a lot of drama actually happened, and I have posted videos on that. Please go check previous videos so you know what actually happened between Erica, Lacon and Prince, the whole drama that actually happened. But in this video, let me just gist you guys too about the drama that happened between Nengi and Ozo. Guys, Ozo kind of asked Nengi, like, Ozo proposed to Nengi. Oh yeah, you heard me. Like, what would you call when somebody say that you spend the rest of your life with me, I want to spend the rest of my life with you, you know, that kind of a thing. That was what Ozo was saying to Nengi last night.
Because I'm here as the one person I know I really want to spend the rest of my life with already. I'm not sure. I don't want to spend this time with anyone else. Like, I really know I've already, you know, like,
and then funny enough, you know, after he went about rambling back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, you know, Nengi now, after he finished, just when we thought that Nengi was going to say something, Nengi yawned. Let's go inside.
Right. There's no love in my
world. Hey. Let's go inside.
And I'm like, Nengi, what is Nengi, try now, just small, try and just be a little bit free with this guy, because it just feels like when he goes all out being all mushy with you, the next thing you just say one silly thing or just do one silly thing, it just looks as if his energy or what he's saying didn't mean jack shit to you. Well, I think it doesn't, but maybe you never can say, you get. So guys, actually, after the whole drama that happened yesterday night between Erica, Prince and Lacon, this morning Erica came down from her head of house lounge and went to meet Kidwire, and Kidwire, they wanted to have a conversation about it. Guess what guys, Erica said she doesn't remember jack shit, and I'm like, girl, you do, girl.
How you feel now?
Just then, I need to sleep, but I can't sleep, yeah.
I'm sure you couldn't sleep until yesterday.
No, I woke up this morning, like, I knew I slept, so I slept. So I slept. I woke up and I can't remember that job. Let me come and see you and talk to you. That's it.
You do. If for any reason this is the first time that Erica was not really drunk, if it's other time, I understand that she was drunk, but yesterday, what happened, she might be tipsy but not drunk, and she could remember. I'm sure she can remember what happened last night. Well, Kidwire did the pleasure of reminding her everything that actually happened last night, and Kidwire expressed displeasure, telling her that if she gets disqualified today, that he will be very, very disappointed and angry at her.
If you get disqualified, it'll
I feel bad.
It'll be hard for me to forgive you for a while.
Really?
Of course. Because you fucked up all your plans, and that would piss me off. Obviously, I'll forgive you, but it really annoyed me. That wasn't the plan.
And I'm like, okay, yeah, you have every right to want to be angry or disappointed because you tried all your best to stop her, but she refused to stop. As in, Erica refused to stop the whole drama, even with all the effort that Kidwire was trying to help her, Kidwire and Prince, which even made her have an issue with Kidwire. But with all the whole thing that now she's forming amnesia and she's just saying that she cannot remember, I now do not understand what is going on, you guys. And then I think Ozo advised her, I don't know if it's Ozo or Kidwire, advised her to apologize to the housemates, and Erica gathered the whole housemates and tender an apology.
The hardest thing I've ever done in my life, admitting that I'm wrong, and I'm very, very sorry for acting out and being stupid and saying a lot of wrong things to different people. And I feel like It's very easy to blame it on alcohol, but I said a lot of things that I feel like even other people, if they take alcohol, they still will not see those things. So I can't really blame it on alcohol.
Well, from my own observation, that apology, you did not, it wasn't necessary for the whole house. And even if you did it, you apologized to the whole house. You should have specifically mentioned Lekon's name and Prince's name. In fact, Lekon most especially, you would have mentioned Lekon's name. She should have mentioned Lekon's name and specifically apologized to Lekon.
I blame it on the fact that I've been angry and frustrated about some other things for a long time. And I need to do something about it because I don't want this to ever happen again. So I'm sorry to each and every one of you for the bad words I said to you people.
Because the whole of that drama really triggered a lot of reaction. I am sure that Erica lost a lot of fans last night due to her action, how she reacted, because even celebrities, they reacted. A lot of celebrities that were stunning her, they just switched immediately to Lekon. And, you know, that was not a wise decision. And people were just commending Lekon based on the fact that he maintained a lot of tranquility, like peace, like he wasn't shaking. Because, like Kidwire was telling her that, if Lekon was a bad person like you're saying, he would have been provoking you. And truthfully, if Lekon was a bad person and really wants Erica to leave, he would have been provoking Erica, because all he needs to say is, Erica, you did it. Yes, you did it. Just insisting that she did it, and she would have fallen into the trap even deeper, because Erica looks like someone that can be very physical when she's pissed, you get. And all she needed was just a little trigger, and that is what Lekon would have done if Lekon truly did not care about her like she is claiming. Anyway, guys, she tendered an apology to the house. I don't know if the housemates, they accepted, if they just listened to her and walked away. But truth be told, that we are still waiting and looking forward to the outcome of everything that actually happened last night. Like, we are waiting for Biggie to address it, whatever it is. Me personally, she goes, she no go, no be my problem. Be that, you get. I really do not care, because there is a consequences for every of our action. When she was acting that way, she should have thought about it, you get. Because she keeps saying that Lekon is her highlight, which I am not supportive of it. Lekon made her his name from the very first day. Lekon trended from the very first day. So she might be thinking that Lekon will be leaving today, that's true eviction, or Lekon is using her to trend. But girl, that's not true. But whatever it is, I just feel like at some point Erica needs to see. Anyway, she says she asked to see a psychologist, but they have not attended to her. And I
negative emotions. This is what's going on. Every time I'm ringing the bell asking for a psychologist, nobody answered. It's not my fault. I didn't ask to be here. My mother and my father made a mistake, and I'm here.
To her, and I think she really does need to see a psychologist. That if they send her home today, I wish she gets a psychologist, whether she's in the house or outside the house. She needs somebody to talk to her for her to calm down, because the rate at which she's going, it's not really going to help her. So I just felt like, let me bring it on here, that there is a wedding. We are supposed to be planning a wedding, the ozones. We are supposed to plan a wedding, you get. Let us plan a wedding and talk about our color. And also, Erica has apologized to the house, triggering reaction from everybody based on her action last night. So I just say, let me come and update you guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please, if you do, give it a thumbs up, leave me a comment in the comment section. I really, really love to read from you guys what your thoughts are, what you feel about the apology, what you feel about Ozo and Nengi's relationship. Well, just leave it in the comment section. I'd love to hear from you. Thank you so very much for watching my video, and I will most definitely see you guys in my next video.